Hi everyone, I'm Murphy Rajanu from Google Quantum AI team. Today I'm very glad to be able to share with you our research on pulse sequence design to mitigate crosstalk at scale. This is a joint work with our intern, Harry Hengren Zhou, Jonathan Devier, Juan, and Vadim from our team. First, I will define what crosstalk effects that we are mitigating. The long-range interactions between qubits. Long-range parallel-like interactions are everywhere in the system, where electromagnetic fields are present. This includes all types of quantum computing systems on the market. First, we have charge-charge interaction through the very familiar Coulomb interaction. But also, we have dipole-dipole coupling even for the system that are charge neutral, but the positive and negative charge are spatially separated. Of course, the two types of interaction decay differently as a function of distance. Secondly, for superconducting qubits, which live in also circuits, we also have a lump element counterpart of these electromagnetic interactions. One important kind is inductive coupling, where if you have a change of electric current in one inductor, which will cause the change of current in a neighboring inductor that share the same electromagnetic field. And secondly, we also have capacitive coupling, similar to the charge-charge interaction, but in the context of the circuit where there's a change of electric field in a current one, if they're connected through a capacitor, then the circuit two there will be a non-zero current flowing between the two circuits. And this is shown in a very simple experiment where if you put a light bulb between two power lines, the light bulb will be light up, although I don't recommend doing this experiment in person. But why do we care about crosstalk in quantum computing system, in particular the superconducting qubit system? The reason is they are everywhere and it's unavoidable. Here is a circuit of a superconducting qubit where each loop represents a qubit. And we have three loops. The reason is we use a middle qubit to serve as a coupler to control the coupling between the first and third qubit by changing the frequency of this middle qubit. And on the high level, as you can see, the two qubits are connected directly by capacitor and indirectly by this nonlinear oscillator. So it's pretty obvious that there will be crosstalk between the qubits. And on the high level, there are three types of crosstalk. First is a straight capacitive coupling, which happens between the nearest neighbor qubits. As you can see that they directly share a capacitor and indirectly coupled through a middle coupler qubit. You might ask, why can't the middle coupler qubit turn off all unwanted couplings between the qubit 1 and 3? Isn't that the whole purpose of the tunable coupling? The reason is, the main reason is the qubit we have are nonlinear harmonic oscillators whose energy spacing are uneven, which means the capacitive coupling between different levels are nonlinear function of the frequency and therefore cannot be simultaneously zeroed out. And secondly, we also have charge-charge coupling for the simple fact that each superconducting qubit circuit has a capacitor that can host charge and therefore they can interact with each other. And they are because of the Coulomb decay, the leading term is between the diagonal neighbor of the qubit that doesn't directly interact. And lastly, we also have flex crosstalk. The mechanism is very much similar to the inductive coupling, where the control flex into one superconducting squid loop will leak to the neighboring loop and change, which will induce the corresponding change in the frequency of the qubit. So given such prevalent many different channels of crosstalk, what's the overall effect of this in the quantum computation? The simplest benchmark is to look at the gate error. When there is no unwanted crosstalk between qubits, we expect the gate error to be independent of what the neighbors are doing. However, in reality, we see almost a factor of 2 reduction in the increase in gate error when operating CZ gate in parallel. And so in the broader context of a quantum circuit, instead of the beautiful quantum circuit represented in the left, we will be really doing executing a circuit on the right, where we have crosstalk between different pairs of qubit throughout different moments of the circuit. So this brings me to the topic of mitigating crosstalk error using pulse sequence design, while also mitigating other leading error source in our system, such as dephasing. As a brief introduction of the pulse sequence design, or the dynamical decoupling in particular, the main idea is if there are unwanted dynamic in the system represented by this Hamiltonian H total, we can try to compensate the effect of such dynamic by inserting pulse sequence in between the free evolution. If we carry out the mask, assuming each interval is sufficiently short, then the overall effective Hamiltonian of the induced evolution will be a linear sum of the basis transformed Hamiltonian, where the basis is determined by the pulse sequence that we have applied. So if we are managed to flip the sign of the this Hamiltonian every other step, then obviously we can cancel it. And another picture, which is more subtle to explain the effect of dynamic coupling, is illustrated in this video, where if there is unwanted z-phase error that makes the block vector spread out in the xy plane, we can simply flip the sign of the zx rotation half the way, such that the qubits start rotating but in the same angle, but in the opposite direction, which brings the qubit back to exactly its initial state perfectly. So our pulse sequence design will utilize both type of concept shown in these two examples. Now we'll use one slide to explain the gist of our pulse sequence and to mitigate the crosstalk, which is represented in the right part of this Hamiltonian, xx plus yy, and dephasing, which is in the first part of this Hamiltonian. And similar to the refocusing example, we want to flip the sign of the interaction term in this Hamiltonian half of the time. And there are two ways to do this if we only want to cancel out the second term. First is we can add a minus sign in x and y by adding a z pulse on each qubit. Because z anti-commute with x and y, it will add a minus sign to both. A second way is to apply x and y pulse on each one of the two pair of qubit. This is a better choice because x and y also anti-commute with z, which is dephasing in the first term. So we will henceforth use the second pulse sequence to mitigate both dephasing and crosstalk. Now we have to satisfy the constraint once we lay qubit on the grid, where we want to cancel out all crosstalk between n squared choose two many pairs of qubit crosstalk channel. It sounds pretty hard. Luckily, there's a magical matrix called Hadamard matrix. You might be familiar with Hadamard gate, which is a special two-dimensional instance of Hadamard matrix here. And I show also two other cases and the iterative definition. If you look at the property of the Hadamard matrix closely, you will notice that inner product between any row is always zero. And moreover, if we treat each row element as a basis change P, where one means no change and minus one means a flip of the sign for the Pauli frame, then the Hadamard matrix will satisfy all the requirements that we want for the crosstalk cancellation. And this is a graphical illustration for a specific example of four qubit, 2x2 grid. So let's say all the crosstalk we like to cancel are the edges between the six edges between the four qubits. And if we apply the Z Pauli frame transform represented by each row of this four-dimensional Hadamard matrix, you'll realize that if you pick any edge, it'll spend exactly half of the time in the correct sign, the positive sign, half the time in the negative sign. And this is how it works in a figurative sense. So now I will quickly go over some preliminary simulation and experimental result. We simulate the effect of our Hadamard pulse sequence in a distance two surface code circuit and compare it with more conventional simple X echo, where we apply X gate idle qubits. And also compare it against a no pulse sequence circuit using our noisy simulator that the viewer developed. And we see a factor of up to 3 reduction in the detection rate in the distance two surface code. So summary and future look, we proposed a scalable pulse sequence, Hadamard pulse sequence, to cancel out crosstalk between qubit of any range during idle. And we benchmarked the effectiveness of this pulse sequence in both simulation and experiment and showed up to factor of 3 reduction in error rate. Although more work is in place to study a pulse sequence for the error-corrected quantum circuit. Thank you very much. And I would like to thank my collaborator, especially Henry Yuan, who carried out a heavy lifting of this work, and Jonathan, Devere, Juan, and Vadim. Thank you very much.